This video is about how to read Excel files with Python. For example, I have here a simple items XLSX file with the following data. Not much, but it can be a quite large file with, for example, 40 columns and 10,000 rows. So I want to read the file and make a list of dictionaries with this data. And first of all, to read Excel files, I have to install the Openpyxl library. And in your Python script, let's import the load workbook function. And to read an Excel file, I have to call this function, load workbook. And pass into it the path to the file I want to open. And as my Excel file is in the same directory as my Python script, I can pass into the load workbook function just its name. So in my case, it's items XLSX file. Let's save the result to the book variable. Okay. The next step, I have to get the working spreadsheet. And we can get all sheets by using the sheet names property. Print book sheet names. And I've got a list with the sheets 1. And to get the particular sheet, we can use square brackets like with the dictionaries and specify there the title of a sheet. Sheet 1. Or we can use the active property to get the active sheet. Let's save the sheets to a variable. Now let's get all rows of the sheet. I can get all rows with using of the rows property. Sheets rows. And the rows property will return a generator object. Print type rows. Class generator. It's an iterable object, but not a collection of rows. And it means that we are unable to get an element of the generator by its index. And all we can do is to get only the next value of a generator. For example, let's create a simple generator in the console. Python, Control L, define a function, and I want to get integers from 0 to 4. And my generator will yield the I variable. Let's create a generator object. I'm calling the gen function. It's a generator. Now let's get the generator's value. And to do it, I have to pass the generator object, the g variable, into the next function. I got 0. Again. Now I got 1. Each time I call the next function, I always get the next value of the generator. And if I iterate the generator in a for loop, for I in g, we can see that iterations are started from 2, from the value where generator stopped at the last time. So let's back to our rows. Rows is the generator, and my file has the titles of the columns in the first row. So let's get the first row to get these titles. To get the first row, I have to pass the rows generator into the next function, like I did in the terminal, rows, and save it to a headers variable, print headers. And we can see that the headers is the list of two elements. Each element is the cell object, but not the value of the cell. And to get the values of the cells, I have to use the value property. We can use here a for loop or a list comprehension, an expression that will return a list. So, in this case, the headers will be a list, and I need elements of the list for cell in next rows. But I need not cells themselves, I need its value property. So cell value for each cell in the next rows list. I can delete this definition and let's print headers. And this time I got a list with the item and price. And now I want to get all the rest rows and combine them with the headers list to get dictionaries with the structure, where there is an item key with some value and the price key with some value. So, to get the rest rows, I want to use a for loop. For row in rows. And I want to remind you that the rows variable is the generator object, and it will yield values from the value he stopped last time. And it means that it will continue to yield data from the second row, because the first row I already used for our headers. So, at the moment, we have two lists. The headers list. And the second list is the raw list or a tuple that we will get on each iteration of the for loop. And again, the raw tuple or list is something like cell 1 and cell 2. And I want to peg this data into a dictionary, where the elements of the header list will become keys and the element of each row list will become the values. And as you probably know, we can combine these two lists with the zip function. And zip function will return a special zip object that's something like a list of tuples, where each element is a combination of our two lists. For example, its first element will be a tuple combined from the first elements of our lists. So it'll be item, the first element of the headers list, and the cell 1, the first element of the raw list. And the second element will be price and cell 2. Let's create an empty dictionary data where we will store our data. Empty dictionary. And now I have to start a new nested for loop for item in zip. The first list is a headers list and the second list is the raw list. This one. The zip function will create a zip object, a terrible object, and the item variable on each iteration of the for loop will get a tuple like this. And so I can unpack the tuple into variables. It'll be the title variable and the cell variable. And now I want to write these variables into the data dictionary. Data key title gets the value of the cell variable value attribute. So let's print data somewhere out of the inner for loop. Print data. And we can see our dictionaries. Let's create a list, an empty list, for example, all rows. And here outside of the inner for loop, I want to append the all rows list with the data dictionary. Let's print the all rows list. And we can see a list of dictionaries with all data we have in the items XLSX file. So it's working. If you like the video, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching.